The iconic building of Knightley has been the face of music at Exeter for many years. When the university had its own music department, it was one of the key academic buildings. And in 2006, when the academic department was closed, Knightley became the home of the music office. Charged with defending the interests of extracurricular music at Exeter, the music office secured funding for K House, a state-of-the-art building on the outskirts of campus. And the university has since developed a reputation for having a strong musical tradition outside of academia. However, over Easter, the university announced plans to convert Knightley into postgraduate and staff offices for a new department, the highly anticipated Strategy and Security Institute. We spoke to the head of Arts and Culture Services, Dom Jinks, about the move. So the creation of the new department is obviously good news for the university, but what does it mean for the facilities that currently reside in Knightley?
Well, practically what it means is that we will have to move the operation of extracurricular music from Knightley and Clayden to Cornwall House. And I think it's worth pointing out that it's not a like-for-like swap, because there is a reduction in terms of the number of practice rooms that there will be currently in Knightley and Clayden to that of Cornwall House.
What can you tell us about the reasons for the move?
Well, there are a number of reasons for the move from Knightley. First of all, there is a background of the development of K House Duryard, which is the music facility over towards the Duryard Halls. K House Duryard came with an investment of $2.3 million, so you know, huge investment for extracurricular music, and now a fantastic facility for music. When that was created, and there were discussions about the development, which was about 4 years ago, there was a meeting with Xtunes and Campus Services, and there was an understanding that tenancy at Knightley and Clayden would be on a short-term basis until the university made a decision on the long-term implications of Knightley and Clayden. So that time now is imminent, with the Strategy and Security Institute being proposed to move in there for next academic year.
So many students are concerned about the loss of the homely feel in Knightley. But what will the advantages be to the move to Cornwall House?
Well, there's no denying Knightley's a fantastic building. It's a historic home, but I think because it's a historic home, it comes with its problems, and it is a dilapidated building. And we've seen leaking roofs, flooding basements, and really a space that's not fit for purpose for music to be carried out within that building. And one of our priorities is obviously the safety of students. So I think one of the major advantages with Cornwall House is that there is £200,000 that has been allocated specifically for the redevelopment of those spaces for music. So every room will be acoustically soundproofed, there will be a new office, a PC cluster, a slightly smaller library, but those spaces will be fit for purpose for music to be carried out within Cornwall House.
Thank you very much for talking to us, Dom. We also spoke to Mark Barretto about the music officer's view on the move. Can you give us an outline of the proposed plans?
Yeah, the proposed plans are that we relocate temporarily from Knightley and Clayden down to K House and Duryard. That's proposed to take place on the 27th and the 28th of June. We'll set up a new music office temporarily in K House from July the 1st, and that'll be there until right about the end of August, beginning of September. And then in time for Freshers Week, we'll move into new premises in Cornwall House.
How will the move impact music societies in terms of practice space and facilities?
Okay, in terms of practice space and facilities at Cornwall House, they will have 8 practice rooms, which will include a large seminar room similar to the one in Knightley. They'll also have 7 practice rooms on the lower ground floor, all of which will be soundproofed. And this is quite important to confirm, in that following a meeting we had yesterday with Estate Development and the acoustician who's been employed to look at the building, measures are being put in place for walls to be soundproofed, doors as well, and particularly for a very large soundproof door to be placed between the seminar room and the existing lemmy, so that there'll be no disturbance or very limited disturbance of noise, both coming from the music people practicing and also any other activity taking place within Cornwall House.
How do you plan to increase security in Cornwall House?
Okay, the opening hours of the building will remain very much the same as the music buildings at the moment. So 8:30 in the morning through to 11:30 midnight, 7 days a week. In terms of security for the areas, there'll be a mixture of traditional locks with keys, keypad locks, and also swipe card security as well.
A lot of students are concerned that the move to Cornwall House will be detrimental to music at Exeter with the loss of facilities such as the music library. What are your responses to those claims?
I think in the past, music, if you look at the history of our existence in Clayden and Knightley, we moved into these buildings in the past pretty much on the back of the period when music was available as a taught subject. That has changed. Music has changed on campus dramatically. And now we have 30 music societies that cover pretty much every genre of music and singing. And I think what's going to be available now is going to help supplement that. And there will be room for expansion. Nobody's saying that this is as far as music can go. There will always be that negotiation between music, academic services, campus services, and estate development. Nobody knows what's going to happen in the future, how the premises will change across the whole university. But certainly now, there's been a great need to provide accommodation for postgraduate research, and Knightley is the best place on campus for that to happen.
Thank you very much for talking to us, Mark. Next, we're going to be talking to Jade and Kit from Xtunes and Ed Gillings, the organiser of Occupy Knightley.
Well, I was originally the person who suggested the idea, and I've been taking charge of the Facebook event and trying to get everything going, but I've had a lot of help from other musicians, so it's really been quite a nice sort of community effort. Basically, we're just trying to get as many people as we can to come over to the building, pop in, sign a book that we've got, a sort of goodbye Knightley thing. We've sort of transitioned into this being a bit of a goodbye, and we're making a video, so we're just sort of trying to chill and have a lot of fun.
My priorities for me have been trying to make sure that the students have a way of getting their points across to me, so they set up a Facebook group, which has been very successful, and an online petition, and I've been trying to take that to the Guild.
They've been holding meetings, like there was one just yesterday, where they got all of the society presidents to come along and explain to us exactly what was going to happen, so everyone seems pretty well informed now, and it seems like it's going to run quite smoothly.
It's good that the university is spending money on Cornwall House and making sure it's soundproofed, and we hope that as Xtunes and its affiliate societies continue to grow, that the university will respond to that demand.
We are only an extracurricular department in this university, and although we are the largest extracurricular music department in the country, we still can't stand against an academic department that's going to boost the university's research levels. Obviously, I'm not happy at all that we're losing Knightley. No one is really, you know, we're all very attached to this place. The atmosphere and the spirit in this building is so close-knit. You know, people have described it in their emails to me as a family kind of feeling, and that's just something we don't want to lose.
So it's goodbye to Knightley. Looking through this book filled with musical memories and fond farewells, it's clear that this building will be missed by students and staff alike. But nevertheless, the future is bright for music here at Exeter. Kate Gray, XTV News, Knightley.